In this video, I'm going to show how to convert an halogen to LED. So that's my LED sitting now in a halogen case. So here you have a halogen. I've just taken the glass front off. So there's a halogen sitting across there, and you just pull it to one side. That's it out. Leave it down there. So here we have an LED. They're 15 watts, and you can just put them in there. But that's not what I'm going to be doing today. But they are a really fast way if you want to convert your 500 watt halogen, so that's 500 watts of electricity, over to 15 watts of electricity. So it's a huge saving in energy. So first thing I did was, when I was converting it over to this type of system, I was just to undo this nut real quick, and then we take out the reflector. If it wants to come out. Okay, with two hands I got the reflector out. You can actually see the heat scored marks off the previous bulb. So that's 500 watts, and a lot of that is used up as heat. So the LED would be far more efficient. So what I did was, I removed the two nuts. You take out this whole little assembly here. You tap both of these with a hammer. They're only made of ceramics, so they should break off easy enough, or just cut the wires, but you need the cable anyway. So with these removed, I put it into a vise and just gently just bent this little piece of metal, or this little tab, just over at 90 degrees. So if you look at it carefully, you can see it goes across, it goes up, and then it will be going across again. And where it bends across, it'll actually be higher than this point here. So the idea is, with this one, let's take the lid off. You can see that it looks like, so there's a big square or rectangle just here, and two little fingers off left and right. So what the way it works is, you can put down your reflector, like what I have here, and it bolts again, like normally, into this point here. Then the little tabs that I said you bend, so they will be drilled onto, or drilled through the aluminium, and they'll be bolted to those little tabs. So now you have a base to work off. Then you put down your heat compound paste in just a big blob just in the center. Don't put loads of little ones, because you end up with little air bubbles. So just one in the center, a big decent blob, and then just squirt or push down your LED straight onto it, and you'll see it coming out the sides. Then just put in your, I use pot rivets because they're nice and handy, just put them on, and then just solder your two wires straight on, and the job is done. It's so simple. I haven't found anyone else on the internet or on YouTube that's done it this way. Everyone else wants to remove all of this. Come on, phone, focus. There you go. Remove everything inside it, put the chip straight onto the back wall, then drill through the back wall, because you're using the heat sink back here. But remember, the last bulb was 50 watts. And that's how much heat sinking it had. You're using 10 watts. So that little bit of aluminium should be perfect. And if you do drill through the back of it, well, now your light is no longer waterproof, which is what I wanted to be, just waterproof. So that would kind of defeat the purpose. And this way, when the bulb, or the chip, or the board, I suppose, when it burns out, it will eventually burn out. All I have to do is drill out the two pot rivets, desolder the two wires, put in your new chip, new bit of heat compound paste, and just put it all back together again. Super fast, and again, it doesn't let the water in, so once the lid goes back on top of it, it will be dry. So that's a really fast way of putting it. It took me probably about half an hour to make, just because I didn't have a clue really what I was doing the first time. I haven't found anyone else on YouTube or on internet anywhere that's done it this way. Everyone else wants to just, like I said, put it straight on the bottom, then you get your reflector, and either shove it down first, and then you cut a hole here, but that kind of defeats the whole purpose of everything. And the other thing is, when you put it down like that, you kind of have to make it then, force it to shape around all these contours, which it doesn't really want to do. And also, because it's, when you push it down, you'll also be dropping a distance here. So this is black here, so that's going to absorb some of your light. So I thought that was kind of defeating the purpose the way it was meant to be done. Like, really, if you got like aluminium tape, yeah, you could put it on, but it would take so long to do. This was a much faster way of doing it. So again, just real quick, you take this out, you bend it, these at 90 degrees, but bend them that they're higher than this point here. It's only maybe 1 or 2 mil. You might even have to straighten the whole thing and just bring this little fold mark closer back here, and then put the next fold in just to get enough across, up and across again. Then just cut out my piece of aluminium in this kind of rectangle with the two little fingers off left and right. See, the fingers have to be able to slide in through here, through these two gaps here. Of course, you just put a hole in either one of them, bolt it through. So you're using the original screw holes and everything, so it's very, very fast. And everything is modular. So you can just unbolt it really quick, put in your new piece, or like if your bulb does burn out, and put the next one in. And again, like, it's just solder your two wires on, and you're done. So that's my how-to of how to convert a halogen to LED. Of course, if you don't want to go that in that route, these are absolutely perfect. That's 15 watts and they work perfectly. They do burn out eventually, but like at 15 watts, like the cost is so little, and they work pretty impressively. So they just fit straight in like that. So there you go. And I've had this one running until it broke, so I'm replacing that. So I've had this one running for, I think, the last 3 weeks, and it hasn't burned out, it hasn't flickered, I haven't noticed anything negative about it. It turns on, lights up everything, it's 10 watts, it's, I think the bulb cost me, I think it was €1, so it was incredibly cheap. These are a lot more expensive, I think they're about €6 or €7. But again, if you don't want to go down the route of having to modify everything, just they just pop straight in, so that goes back in like that normally, and you just put that in like that, and that's the way it works. Super fast, small bit expensive, small bit of work, but super cheap. And again, everything only has a certain life, just like the ordinary bulbs. These ones, the 50 watts, you know, they'll only have a certain amount of life in them anyway, that so many hours. The same with the bulbs. So like, if anyone says, oh, they last forever, they don't. They do eventually burn out, but I think I've replaced one of them, and I've been running them for the last 3 years. And they're on security lights, they're on and off the whole time. I've never had any problems. The only one that burnt out was there was a door next door, and every time the door would open and close, this would shake ever so slightly, and I think the shaking, the vibration just went through it. So I would have gotten even longer out, more than 3 years out of it. So overall, very impressed.